What is up, guys? My name is Ninja Gamer, and today we will be playing yet another game of Archon Mode, our road to gold. I already told you guys my name, Brain Fart. We are playing with Protoss today, and I am once again playing with my brother Tosh. And yeah, this is actually a rematch against our arch nemesis Unknown Kai and Jake. Actually, they're not our arch nemesis, but it just so happened that I was looking over our previous games and we have actually played against them, so we'll see how this one goes down. They are Terran, and I believe they're making a Reaper. Oh my gosh, I called it. I was correct. It's not bad. Not bad scouting. I'm guessing my brother Tosh is building, because he is the Protoss builder. I am the Terran builder. Well, sometimes I build with Protoss. It just depends. And the Reaper is out, coming at us. That is indeed true. Being controlled by
base is under attack.
Holy crap, that just scared the shit out of me, guys. Alright. Reaper's coming out, destroys the probe. And looks like shit gonna go down.
Base.
Luckily we just got a stalker out. That should be
additional
sufficient to stop this. Alright, I'm gonna stop that. I think when I'm in player perspective mode, it makes all the sounds of the game, so that was kind of annoying. I took that off. Alright, we are trying to stop a two Reaper harass with one stalker. I think that's pretty feasible. Two stalker, yeah, we should pretty much have this under control here. And we have our mothership core. Ooh, he does do a little good job of tricking us. And let's see if he could inflict any damage. Oh man, he is harassing us with his KDA charges, doing loops around us. And I'm kind of an idiot. I should just put one stalker here and one stalker there, but I'm not the best ninja gamer here. In much more exciting news, I just found out that we pretty much got our very very first subscriber, first real subscriber ever, and I'm really happy about that, because, well, yeah, it's just kind of cool to see that some people are watching and at least one person liked it enough to subscribe and was kind enough to subscribe, so thank you so much for subscribing. I really appreciate it, and it means a ton to me and my brother Tosh, because, well, he doesn't really upload the videos, but we reference, you know, videos quite often, and which ones would make for good content. But yeah, this guy's harassing us with a one Reaper, and we're on two base here. We're going Stargate, it looks like. But he's got us at bay here. Nothing too significant. I got a couple stalkers and an oracle. This guy's doing a good job of, I don't know if it's Jake's duty. Jake is very much responsible. Or no, maybe it's Unknown Kai. One of these guys is responsible for this. I think it's Jake. He's in command of the attack, and it's pretty much him and this Reaper taking on the whole world here. Alright, so let's see what the hell is going on in this game. We got a couple stalkers here. And on the Terran side, I think we're pretty much even as far as expansions go. We got our Oracle up. One thing that we like to do is go early Oracle, especially on these maps where it's hard to scout them. We get the Oracle, see what's going on, kill some SCVs, everyone's happy. So that is what I believe is going to happen right now. Looks like Terran is pretty much going hardcore MM with about 6 barracks and a double engineering bay. Yeah, I needed to use the Oracle. Looks like I did go ahead and send this Adept to Scout. So we know that he has, probably, we pretty much know at this point that he has his third, but I am unable to look at what he has on the map. And where the hell is that Oracle? I have no idea where it am. I'm really slow. I mean, okay, so he has a third. I'm pretty slow. We're barely just getting our third. So I think he probably has the economic advantage here. The APM advantage goes to them. But we're actually pretty good. 102 is not bad at all. Oh, it looks like Oracle has been doing pretty good work here. 4 kills, 5 kills, 6 kills, 7, oh my gosh, 9, we've gotten 9 kills so far. We've killed 8 workers. That's pretty good. And he's pretty much lifted up all the SCVs. And we've pretty much picked up on the fact that he has a lot of dropships, so I would say the scouting was pretty effective. Got to kill a total of 9 SCVs and figured out that he was going hardcore marine marauder medevac, so quite good here. I'm looping back around in for some more harass, and this is working out to our favor here, guys. 6 kills and 11 kills. We have an instructor and a mentor, a couple medevacs being loaded up. And one Oracle goes down. In the meantime, let's look at army size. The harass continues. Army size is looking like 14 stalkers and 2 Phoenix versus 23 Marines and 2 Marauders. So I would say that's pretty evenly matched so far. And we have 2 Templars. So yeah, I mean, given that we now have a 4th base. Whoa, and look at this drop going down. That was pretty good, guys. I should have picked up on that. I was kind of late on that. But looks like, well, it looks like he didn't kill too many workers. He has only killed 3 workers so far. And we've only lost 7 units, so we are ahead ever so slightly. But with our 4th base coming up, we aren't really behind with 3rd base here. Oh, and hopefully with this blink, that was probably a really bad move by him. Oh, and it looks like the medevac is gonna... Oh, come on. Should've just suicided that medevac. He has literally 1 HP here. Alright, so we're feeling pretty confident. Despite his significant number of barracks, 7 barracks. He's pretty much focusing on a marine heavy army. And if I were him, knowing that I'm going against Protoss, I would probably choose to go a little bit heavier on the Marauders. What are these SCVs doing? Oh, they're repairing the medevac. Ooh, alright, let's see this battle go down. One Psy Storm goes down, another Psy Storm goes down, third Psy Storm goes down. Oh, come on, just go in, Ninja Gamer. Just go in. Why are you running like a pansy? Why are you running like a pansy? Well, 66 units killed, 17 workers destroyed, and we're pretty much on 5 base compared to their 4. So I would say that we have the edge here, and that we could probably just keep pushing, although I was really tentative there. I should have just went in and engaged there, but I guess we'll see how this next encounter goes down. Alright, just go. Go. Just go in and fight. I don't know what is going on in terms of... Let's see what they see here. Alright, they know that we're expanded heavily across the map. It's pretty much divided to the left and right hand side, and so they've decided that they're gonna take out the upper right portion. In the meantime, I'm kind of being an idiot and I didn't actually realize that they're going to the upper right here. I think that might be a hallucination. And let's see how we handle this. Now we are creating Tempests here, and he's pretty much destroyed. We really need to cancel these Tempests and save the money. Well, let's see how this goes. Our hallucinations are effective in absorbing some damage. He hasn't killed the Stargates yet, so that's good. Our Guardian Shield goes down, some Force Fields go down. Templars are going down. Alright, Tempest is up. He's trying to shoot down the Nexus. But can we do it? The Nexus literally has zero shield, or did have zero shield, and whoa, alright. So, despite being able to survive that, that was pretty bad map awareness on my part. So that almost cost us a lot of minerals here. I mean, Tempest cost 300 minerals and 200 gas. We are leading the effort in a counterattack. We were able to take down one dropship. We're still quite ahead. 111 units killed, but he's pretty much evened out the workers killed count. On the resources front, we are... Whoa! And look at all those Marines come in, stimming. 2-2 Marines against 1-0-0. That's one thing that we have to improve upon is upgrades. We don't do a good enough job with upgrades. Alright, that's a shitload of Templars. Oh, look here. I sent a bunch of Zealots down here too. Probably not as effective, because he's got that planetary fortress, and Mothership Core is now here. We've got a shitload of Templars. I mean, this is looking like a pretty good army. This should be enough to destroy him. I mean, I should pretty much just merge the Archons right now. I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, I just tried to Psystorm those Widow Mines. Alright, Templars, don't go to waste. I'm saying that because I'm pretty sure these Templars are going to waste. Because I don't think I'm actually... Oh no, that is a shitload of Psystorm. I did not let those Templars go to waste. Or someone. That might be my brother Tosh controlling these Templars. Pretty sure it was. and he is able to survive just barely here. Archons emerge, but they're pretty much dead by the time they're born. And let's see how things are shaking out at this point. Oh my goodness, we have Tempests. Now, hot dog. 190 units killed, 27 workers killed. We should be in the lead here. Oh lord. Talk about... This is just the worst way to use Tempests. I'm really bad at controlling these air units. Sorry guys. I'm just, that was really awful. And he's like, go where they can't hit you. Yeah, because that was pretty bad. Tempests have lots of range. Yeah, so that was pretty shit on my part.
And then I'm saying, let's do a switcheroo.
So Archon mode is great because if one person starts sucking balls, in this case, my control of Protoss army units is pretty bad. We just do a switch, so now he's gonna control, and now I'm just gonna build. And yeah, I like building. I'm much more of a builder as opposed to a fighter. I like building and strategizing, but I'm not the best in terms of micromanaging the proper engagement for attacking warfare. These zealots though are doing pretty good. 101, and we got a couple upgrades here on the Tempest as well. In terms of the units, we got 8 Tempests and 10 zealots. Oh my gosh, that is a lot. Come on zealots, get in there. Alright, good size storm. One more size storm. Oh no. Isn't it ironic that our Tempests, which cost so much money, are dying from these stupid marines that literally cost 50 minerals, and he is on a mission to take out our base here, and it is clear. In the meantime, we're doing a base trade here. He's taking out our upper right starport center, and we are, we were attacking his expansion. A couple carriers. Oh come on, run, run carriers. Now carriers are awesome because they truly have long range, and slowly these marines are getting whittled down. The Tempests have now come back, but with this exceptional range. Oh my gosh, did you guys see that? These dropships just got utterly destroyed. I mean, it would have been better if he just fought it. Alright, Jake, what's going on through your head? More dropships? Yeah, so... Oh, lots of battles going on here. My brother Tosh going into their main base for their expansion, and these guys taking out our expansion here. Lots of action going on. Alright. Looks like this Nexus is gonna go down. And this stupid planetary fortress has not yet fallen. And we are just dying from marines. So hopefully I realize this and do something about it. Cause this is not a good situation. No, that's good, we're making more stalkers. Increase the unit diversity. And stalkers are doing a lot better against the marines here. That was the better option. Tempests are good for taking down dropships, but by themselves are probably insufficient to take down their whole army here. He's pretty much mined out right there. So we're pretty much on... I don't know who has the economic advantage. 1, 2, 3 base. And we have one, two. I think we're trying to make a third here and a fourth here. So I would say pretty much we're pretty tied as far as mineral intake goes and expansions go. Pretty good use of blink there. And if he can just take down the dropship, let's see if he does it. Alright. This planetary fortress is... this is good. This is what he meant by using the range. Now I'm trying to secure more bases here because we are running out of minerals. So we got one more base here. Just keeping up the carrier count. Trying to get some more upgrades, although that's not coming very well. And let's see how this goes. Templar is still useful. Yeah, the Tempests are very good for taking down air. Oh my gosh, look at that. And we're pretty much maxed out in terms of supply, so you would think that we should be heavily favored here. 5 carriers, 4 Tempests, 17 Stalkers. Ooh. A big attack coming in right here, and let's see how we do. One storm goes down. Oh, see, now what I love about this is I got a couple carriers and a couple, and he doesn't feel like he can break that. He's just like, forget it. Surprisingly, this thing is still alive. Now we got a couple carriers in the mix. He's really in trouble. He is really in trouble here now, guys. I think we have finally taken the upper hand with the mix of carriers, stalkers, tempests, and templars. I mean, we seem to be in a pretty good shape here. We really need to be targeting, there you go, those dropships. And yeah, he really can't do much here. We got a couple carriers at each expansion to protect them, picking off his dropships. So 2 carriers here. Nope. Got this army protecting this expansion. A couple Templars here. And things seem to be turning to our favor, and we are heavily ahead of them in terms of minerals. I believe we have definitely killed a lot more of them. 400 units killed. Granted, he is just pumping out marines. Yeah, he's just got... I wonder if he got the shield. He must have the shield. Let's see. Upgrades. Yeah, he's got the combat shields. That's good. Oh my goodness. We just can't take him down. This is just a war of attrition, guys. Never-ending supply of minerals or marines. These guys are crazy. Got 20 kills, 14 kills, 20 kills, 11 kills, 21. That is just insane. He's just picking them off from the back. They are excellent long-range fighters. And I am trying to secure this other base for us. I don't even know. Okay, oh, looks like that base went down. So now he's really in trouble because I don't think he's pretty much down to one base. To our 1, 2, 3. Well, I guess you could say 2 base. Alright, 3 base, sorry. So 1 base to 3 base, guys. And 190 supply to 82. I think we pretty much have this one in the bag, but he has, or they have, put up a very good fight. But I think my brother Tosh has done a really good job of utilizing the Templars to never let the pressure down as far as their expansion and really making them go on the defense rather than the offense. And a good unit mix has allowed us to really dominate the Marines and the army that he's throwing us with, because yeah, there ain't much he can do at this point. Alright, let's see if the stalkers cover him. Nice. It's excellent use of stalkers to back up the army, and that is pretty much GG, guys. So that is pretty much gonna be it. I know this was a little bit longer than usual, but I hope you guys enjoyed this game, and please consider liking, subscribing, or leaving a comment. We have a lot of exciting content coming your way. As a sneak peek, we just reached gold, and it's so much harder in that league, so I will be posting our videos leading up to that point, and pretty much slowly transition into gold league play videos. But I do have a lot more videos to post until we reach that point, because it did take us quite a while. So thanks again for watching, and please consider subscribing, and I hope you guys have a fantastic day. Bye.